بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. Honorable Chief Guest, respected teachers and my dear Islamic sisters, today my topic is about people of knowledge and the people of wealth. My dear sisters, today's age is a materialistic age. It means madda parasti. Each and every person is running after a materialism. This atmosphere have even affected the scholars. Shaitan and desires have paved way them in this regard. The result was that the scholars were removed from their life purpose and they too jumped into a materialism like others. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated, "Iqra'ul Qur'ana wa'malu bih wa la ta'kulu." You all read the Quran and do good deeds from it and don't make it a reason for a materialism. Rawahu Ahmad. Whatever, it's amazing to see that they have developed a kind of allergic from member of mihrab and they are slipping down from dars o tadris. Why? The purpose of giving a degree is nothing but to convey the message of a truth to the coming generation. My dear sisters, satisfaction and happy, which once was a character of a scholars, now it is being destroyed at the doors of a wealthy people. Each and everything of the world has its own identity. As the tree by its fruit, and moon by its cool light, and sun by its shining. In the same way, the religious scholars were also known by their good deeds and characters. That is why a scholar holds the most popular position in the society. My dear sisters, scholars are the successors of the prophets. The scholars, in sense, convey the religion brought by the prophets to the coming generation in the same way as the prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah An-Nahl, verse number 44, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأنزلنا إليك الذكرى لتبين للناس ما نزل إليه. Translation, we have sent down what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's the dhikr. It means Quran, that you may clearly explain to the mankind what is sent down for them. My dear sisters, the prophets have a crown of a prophethood and the scholars have a turban of a knowledge. The mission of prophet and scholars was nothing but to call the people to the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 73, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وجعلناهم أئمة يهدون بأمرنا. And we have made them leaders, guiding mankind by our commands. The scholars were selected people of the truth. My dear sisters, the eyes of history have also seen such scenes where kings themselves used to come walking towards the people of knowledge. But the self-respect of the scholars was such that they rejected their huge offerings. Once there was a time when scholars were so true that their words and actions was attracted for a large crowd of our people. These wealthy people are spending their wealth on their fellow wealthy people, but never bothered to solve the problem of their imams and alims. My dear sisters, according to my understanding, the solution for this problem is that the people of wealth and the people of knowledge come close to each other. It is only with their cooperation the Ummah will be successful. If the people of wealth keep the people of knowledge free from the tension of their livelihood, then the people of knowledge will become a good servant of our deen. Hence, we have to live a life which Allah's life. At last, I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Lord, please make us a good servant of our deen. Amin summa amin. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.